Hey guys, how you doing? I'm Nate Barger. Welcome to my channel. Today we're going to talk about cash reserves. Just all the reserves you got on the house? Psh, you screwed, man. Let me tell you why. Whenever you go through a property, here's what we do. I'm going to get a list together because I work better this way. Okay, guys? You okay with that? Can you guys get a pen and paper out? I'm going to walk through a door. I'm going to walk through your house with you, okay? I'm going to walk through the door. I'm going to put my hand on the right wall. We're going to drive all the way down this wall. What I want to do is I want to look at, are there any cracks in the walls? This is on the interior. We're just going to cover the interior today. We're going to cover the exterior too. Don't worry about it. So we're going to go through this house. And we're going to look at the outlets. How do the outlets look? Are they copper or are they aluminum? If they're aluminum, have they been retrofitted with what's called alumicons? If they have they been fitted properly? And here's why, guys. Alumicons, you have to torque down to 10 pounds of torque for a 12 wire, and for a 10 wire, 15 pounds of torque. And if that's not done, then it's not properly retrofitted. So then we're going to move on. We're going to look at the baseboard. We're going to look at the floor. We're going to see if the baseboard and the floor is level. If it's not, what's causing that? We're going to look for that issue when we go down into the basement. Assuming we walk around, we're going to look at the doors. Do the doors work? Do the locks work? Do they hinge properly? Do we have any broken doors? And let's say we got some doors and they're starting to show some wear and tear. Probably going to have to maybe replace the doors. A lot of times we do this doing the BRRRR. That's why I like to do the BRRRR, because then I'm putting all new stuff in and not saying, well, it's good now, but in 5 years, it's going to be bad. Really, when you're setting up your cash reserves, you're going to look at these big ticket items. Your flooring. Because if you're going to pay for your flooring out of cash flow, you buy the property, flooring's 3 years old, you know you're going to have to replace it in a year or two. How are you going to save enough money up in reserves to pay for the flooring? You're not. It's going to dig into your cash flow. You want your cash flow to be consistent. We'll go over what cash flow is for those of you who don't know. For anybody that knows what cash flow is, respond below. Tell them what cash flow is. Tell them how much money you got in cash flow. And tell them what your biggest asset is and how much cash flow you got. So let's say we walk around to the kitchen, the appliances. If the appliances are 5-6 years old, man, I'm budgeting to replace those bad boys. If I'm gonna hold this thing for 5 years, I want that money up front. Here's how you're gonna do it. So outlets, let's say electric's good. Let's say the whole building's gonna need painted. Say the building needs $2,000 paint. It's gonna need painted in, let's say, 4 years, right? Let's say the flooring is going to need redone in 2 years. Let's say that's another $2,000. Cabinets, let's say the cabinets got 5 years left in them. Cabinets are going to be $2,500, cabinets and countertop. Let's say the appliances are, you know, 5 years old. You probably get 10 years out of them. So I'm going to say an appliance suite is going to cost, let's just say it's a $1,000 appliance suite. I'm going to budget half of that. That's $500. Let's say the furnace is 15 years old and the outside AC unit is 12 years old. They're beyond their useful life. But if you know how to work on these things, furnaces don't really, what breaks on them? Unless the heat exchanger breaks, most of the time we're able to fix and repair those. The outside unit, unless it's the compressor that breaks, we're able to repair those. So let's say that each one of those items cost me and my partners, let's say, $1,200 installed for the outside AC unit, which I know you're saying you can't get it done that cheap, but that's what we get them done for. And let's say we had to replace the line set because that old R22 unit and the 410A take a different line set, different pressures. You need a bigger line set for the 410. That's going to cost, well, right now they're up to $320. They used to be $120. But let's say on the install, that's going to cost $320 plus another $300 on the install. So let's say that's $700. I'm going to say the probability on this house of that breaking is about 50%. Let's go through and let's add all this up, guys. This is going to be your five-year need. You got $2,000 plus $2,000 plus $2,500 plus $500 plus $2,300 plus $2,000. So in addition to your purchase price, your closing cost, you're going to need $11,300 over the next 5 years. But let's say we're going to set aside reserves out of this property every month of $60. So 60 times 60 a month times 60 months is going to give you $3,600. So you had $11,300. I'm going to times that by 0.075. I want a 7.5% contingency. Times 11,300 times 1.075. That gives me $12,147.50. We'll let them keep that. Minus the $3,600 that I'm going to get in reserves. That means that on this property, for me to be comfortable, I need to have a reserve account of $8,547.50. So make sure you understand what cash reserves are, and make sure that you are. I got my buddy Steve Rice, my partner, man. He's a master. He put this master spreadsheet together. Spreadsheet is in the course on how we do our reserves. And we got a video in there too. But guys, man, make sure you got plenty of reserves. You'd rather have more reserves and not enough. So guys, I hope that was helpful. If you like that, and let me know below. If you guys could comment and let me know some of the bigger items that you've ever had go break, go bad. One of the biggest unexpected things that I found when I first got into property is get you a camera. They're about $500 if you're going to be buying. Stick them down in that sewer line. You want to know from the house to the street, is your underground plumbing good? Because the worst thing you can do is you buy a property, that line's not good. Guess what, guys? Tenant's going to call, hey, I got a sewer backup, man. The whole bathtub's got stuff flying out of it. There's stuff seeping out from underneath the toilet. That's category 3. Thank you for your time, guys. Make sure you subscribe to my channel. Hit the like button. Crush the like button. Crush it. And click on the...